So, Mortal Kombat 1 is out, and here I was, playing the campaign and having a good time for the most part. The character interactions are interesting, the gameplay is fun, the stages are frickin' beautiful, and I was getting myself really immersed into the Mortal Kombat universe. But then Nitara showed up, and my immersion was immediately broken.
That blade's enchanted!
It was forged to destroy evil. It's slain many of your vampire kind.
We can't help what we are. That we feed on blood doesn't make us evil.
No, don't like that.
And I wasn't alone either.
That we feed on blood doesn't make us evil.
Well,
Dude, someone didn't get the notes.
Oh my god!
Somebody missed the notes!
Okay, this is not about her acting. It literally just sounds like it was recorded somewhere else.
With just a few lines of phoned-in, lifeless dialogue, my experience of Mortal Kombat 1 was immediately compromised, made worse by the fact that literally everybody else in the game has Oscar-worthy levels of voice acting.
Your reign is over, Sindel!
I remember the weak, sickly boy you were. How your father fought to push you past your infirmities. Now you repay him by spitting on his ideals? Your revolt shreds every value he held dear.
From our masked ninjas who all speak with a muffled quality to them to capture the sound of them speaking behind a mask.
The only way in is over the walls.
We must find a less guarded section before attempting an ascent. Finally, we face a worthy foe.
To the devious Shang Tsung, who sounds like he is constantly high on his own farts and enjoying every second of it.
I am sure you're asking yourself, can I afford to trust a man I have never met? But the true question you must ask is, can I afford not to?
Everyone in this game sounds like they belong in this universe, and their performances reflect that. Unfortunately, the same cannot be said for Megan Fox's portrayal of Nitara, a returning 3D era fighter from Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance, where she sounds like an amateur Twitch streamer who just got their hands on a half-decent microphone.
I have fought them tall ones.
All Earthrealmers will soon know of Eternus. My realm starves, and it's coming here to feed.
That one I will accept.
I mean, seriously, what the fuck happened? How the hell did NetherRealm Studios actually sign off on this performance? Megan sounds like she put about as much effort into her voice performance for Nitara as she did her entire acting career. But NetherRealm is just as much to blame for this. They ultimately were the ones who picked her, directed her, and gave her the green light. I mean, how on God's green earth did someone listen to this and think, yeah, that'll do?
Of course I fly! I have wings!
Are you sure you don't just fall with style?
And the fact that everybody else absolutely nailed their performances shows that NetherRealm clearly knows how to choose good voice actors, making the decision to sign off on Megan Fox's performance even more bizarre. And if you listen to some of her lines, you'll notice that she sounds unusually clear and crisp compared to everybody else.
Umgadi are drilled in the Vaternian martial arts.
Those lessons won't help today.
You're like a nightmare come true.
For others, I'm a fantasy.
Everyone else's dialogue have a level of depth to them. There's a grittiness and a sharpness to it that fits with the brutal and harsh world of Mortal Kombat. Megan's delivery of Nitara is completely absent of this, of any kind of depth or reverb that you hear in the delivery of the other voice actors in this game, which makes her subpar performance stand out even more compared to the rest of the cast. And I swear, there are a couple of lines that actually sounds like they have been touched up, and they don't sound half bad.
I'll steal Datusha and kill you with it.
You are welcome to try.
If you're looking to feed on Shang Tsung, he isn't here.
Actually, it's you I want to nibble on.
This isn't the first time we've had a celebrity take on the role of an established character in the Mortal Kombat universe. Rhonda Rousey played Sonya Blade in Mortal Kombat 11, and back then she got a ton of flack for her somewhat flat performance of Sonya.
An officer exchange program?
I will hone your troops to a fine edge.
Seriously, not liking this idea.
Jackie, take my advice.
You gotta win this fight first.
That's the spirit.
These are amazing.
Are you selling?
Yes. As far as I know, I'm the first guy in the whole world to make a working physical model of the flat Earth.
But compared to Megan Fox, she sounds like a goddamn Emmy Award-winning voice actor. And in some ways, she can be forgiven since she is a WWE wrestler first, compared to Megan Fox, who is actually an actor.
Allegedly.
Which brings me to my next point, because on paper, Megan Fox actually fits pretty well as an actor pick for Nitara. Nitara is a vampire from Viternis, a realm outside of Outworld. She has the likeness of Megan Fox with bat-like wings and a succubus-inspired design. She's easily the most mobile fighter in the game. Able to dash in and out of the air freely for combos. Along with a blood sacrifice mechanic that grants her access to unique special moves. Now, one of Megan Fox's notable performances was her role as Jennifer in Jennifer's Body, a horror movie about a student who becomes possessed by a demon and turns into a succubus after she is sacrificed to Satan. You gotta admit, it's a pretty apt parallel to who she ended up playing in Mortal Kombat 1. And you'll notice throughout this video that while her actual dialogue sounds like dog shit, her screeches, screams, and grunts all sound pretty spot on.
So General Shao casts his lot with Outworld's enemies against me. He's a fool to ally with you blood-sucking fiends.
That was her best line.
Yo! And that's because they were not performed by Megan Fox. They were all performed by an actual voice actor named Christina V, known for playing Killua in Hunter x Hunter, Tulin from The Legends of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom, and Shantae from the Shantae series, amongst many, many others. And I'm sure if she was the one to actually have voiced Nitara, then there would be no reason for this video to exist, as we would have a voice actor on par with everybody else in Mortal Kombat 1. But unfortunately, NetherRealm Studios felt they had to put the obligatory celebrity cameo to drive up sales of the game, and in doing so, they potentially compromised an otherwise well-designed character that is really fun to play in the grand scheme of things. I think you have to be really careful when you put a celebrity cameo in your game, because ultimately, because they're so well known, it's hard not to hear that celebrity as opposed to the character that you're trying to portray. They had the chance to do it right with Nitara because Nitara was never voiced in Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance, so we never had that established voice as a reference compared to Sonya Blade in Mortal Kombat 11, where they randomly made Rhonda Rousey the voice actor, whereas before she had been already voiced by different voice actors with high quality talent. I reckon if they had treated Megan Fox's appearance the same way they did Jean-Claude Van Damme as Johnny Cage, and have her as a secondary skin, whilst keeping Christina V as the main actor, I think that would have been a great compromise with having a celebrity guest appearance without potentially compromising an established character. Hopefully NetherRealm learns from this and thinks twice before considering putting in an obligatory celebrity appearance again, but it sounds like they got bigger problems on their hands right now. But that's my two cents on Megan Fox's performance as Nitara. I'm not usually the one to complain about things on this channel, but it really did take away from my experience of this game. But what do you think? Do you agree, disagree, or don't give a shit? Let me know in the comments below, and let me know your thoughts on the game so far. I make videos on fighting game analyses just like this for Smash and Street Fighter, so be sure to subscribe if you're interested and want to stick around. And give the video a like while you're at it, because I had to listen to over half an hour of Megan Fox's intros for Nitara, and it was fucking hell. Anyways, take care everyone, and I'll see you in the next one.